Manila's defense chief becomes the latest government official to flag the risk posed by the pogo industry. He fears syndicates are using legitimate pogo players as a cover for their criminal activities. Victoria Tulad reports.
No less than Philippine Defense Secretary Gilberto Chodoro has raised the alarm over criminal syndicates posing as legitimate offshore gaming operators, calling it a national security concern. The defense chief says illegal pogo operations weaken the country's financial standing and corrupt society. But the Philippine military does not share the secretary's assessment.
So for now, that is not considered as a threat to national security. In terms of the armed forces of the Philippines, we remain committed to maintaining a balanced approach in safeguarding our economic interests, because it also poses economic interests, while prioritizing the well-being and security of our citizens.
As authorities continue to uncover unlawful pogo activities, a security analyst floated the possibility of pogos allegedly being used by China as a Trojan horse.
They select lucrative cities, and some of which they select key strategic locations and infrastructures that are near camps and bases, military camps and police camps abroad.
The National Intelligence Coordinating Agency, or NICA, says they are assessing all potential threats posed by the pogo industry. This comes as relevant agencies verify the authenticity of Chinese military uniforms found at the Lucky South 99, a massive pogo hub recently raided in Porac, Pampanga, as well as suspected communications equipment seized at a pogo facility in Pasay City.
Based on whatever findings na nakikita ng PAOK, titignan natin ulit kung sino yung tinatawag natin mga possible sleepers. Okay? They are there on some legitimate business, but mayroon din silang other intention or plano.
NICA is also gathering information related to Bamban Tarlac Mayor Alice Go, who is suspected of having ties with criminal syndicates and illegal pogos. On the sixth day of the inspection in Lucky South 99 in Porac, Pampanga, authorities once again found alleged Chinese military uniforms, contraband, and suspected torture devices. Authorities also seized more digital devices and discovered a security monitoring system showing almost the entire compound. According to Presidential Anti-Organized Crime Commission Chief Undersecretary Gilbert Cruz, it might take them 5 more days before they can finish searching the whole area. Authorities are looking to file cases, including human trafficking, against at least 15 individuals behind the illegal pogo hub. Based on records from the Philippine Amusement and Gaming Corporation, or PAGCOR, PAOK estimates the number of illegal pogos in the country to be more than 300, mostly operating in Metro Manila and Luzon.
All of them probably have their license before. Kaya lang, nung naramdaman po nila na they will not be issued the renewal dahil may mga violations po silang ginagawa, hindi na po sila nag-apply.
Undersecretary Gilbert Cruz insists pogo operations cannot go unnoticed.
Paggabi, kita mo ilaw na ilaw yung ano, yung building. Number two, yung nagkalat pong foreign nationals sa paligid. Number three, yung mga stores like groceries, restaurants na nagkakalat po sa isang lugar na malapit po sa pogo na yun. Ibig sabihin po, may pogo talaga doon.
According to the PAOK, there are only 46 to 49 legitimate pogos. The Justice Department, for its part, believes it's high time for government to weigh the pros and cons of the pogo industry. DOJ Undersecretary Raul Vasquez says the processes in monitoring and granting licenses to pogos need to be reviewed. Senator Amy Marcos agrees as she calls on Philippine Amusement and Gaming Corporation to suspend the processing of new pogo applications. Marcos is opposed to a total ban on pogos. Philippine House Speaker Martin Romualde says he is open to hearing issues concerning pogo hubs. Victoria Tulad, ABS-CBN News.
Six followers of fugitive televangelist Apollo Quiboloy set to be charged with obstruction of justice. They allegedly tried to assault policemen who served warrants of arrest for Quiboloy Monday. Police Colonel Gene Fajardo says the arresting officers were hit by a water cannon while trying to enter the Kingdom of Jesus Christ compound in Davao City. Colonel Fajardo says Kibuloy's followers also used minors as a human barricade at the compound's entrance. The PNP also dismissing former President Rodrigo Duterte's accusation the large police contingent which served the arrest warrants was an overkill.
Nakakalungkot po na doon po sa area po ng Glory Mountain ay may mga bata pa pong talagang pinangharang doon sa ating mga tauhan. Sana nakikiusap po tayo sa mga magulang po ng mga bata pong ito na alalahanin din po natin. Tayo po dapat ang unang pumoprotekta sa ating mga maliliit na anak. At kung nakikita nyo po doon sa video, ang talagang mga pinangharang ay mga bata na one way or another nasaktan.
The Philippine Vice President, meanwhile, tells law enforcers to serve arrest warrants in a humane and orderly manner. Like her father, Vice President Sara Duterte also questioned what she called an excessive display of force when the police attempted to serve arrest warrants against Pastor Apollo Kibuloy. The former president is the property administrator of Kibuloy's church.
Mag-implementa. Arrest warrants, search warrants, let us make sure that we respect the innocent civilians, the ordinary citizens, especially ang mga bata. Because kanang trauma sa ingon ana, kagubot sa pag-implement lang sa simpleng warrant of arrest, wala takibaloon sa epekto ana sa ilahang pagdako.
The Davao Regional Police Office insists its personnel acted with utmost consideration for safety during Monday's operations. A likely confirmation of the breakdown of the so-called Uniteam tandem coming from the Vice President herself. Speaking to reporters in Davao, the Vice President, Sara Duterte, said the alliance was only good for the 2022 elections.
Ang Uniteam was the tandem during the 2022 elections, and then tandem of Bongbong Sara during the 2022 elections, and then umanang elections ni Daud Malik. And kapasalamat mi sa ato ang mga kaigsuunan sa ating mga kababayan sa kanilang suporta sa tandem. We are not candidates anymore.
Cracks in the tandem began to show last year, with the vice president being stripped of her confidential funds by the House of Representatives. Her father also attacked President Marcos multiple times, accusing him of using illegal drugs. First Lady Liza Araneta Marcos has also issued statements against the vice president. Defending Philippine territory in the spotlight during Wednesday's celebration of the 126th Independence Day. During his speech in the Philippine capital of Manila, President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. noted, "Freedom does not come for free." But he expressed confidence Filipinos would never back down from protecting the country's rights and sovereignty. His remark comes as the country faces China's aggression in the West Philippine Sea.
Ang kalayaan ay inaalagaan, binabantayan, at ipinaglalaban. Sa sandaling mapabayaan natin ito, maaaring itong mawala at maagaw muli sa atin. Ito ay hindi lamang paggunita sa ating kasaysayan, kung hindi isa ring hamon na patuloy na ipaglaban ang ating kalayaan. Kaya naman, sa pagdiriwang natin ito, binibigyang pugay natin ang lahat ng nag-alay ng buhay at lumaban para sa ating kalayaan at kasarilan, sa ating karapatan bilang insang bansang malaya. Mananatili tayong matatag at hindi tayo matitina.
At least 49 dead after a fire broke out in a building housing foreign workers in Kuwait. Dozens of others were injured, including two Filipinos identified as Julio Montemayor and Michael Deason, who are said to be in critical condition. The Overseas Workers Welfare Administration, meanwhile, assures the families of government assistance.
We've already contacted their families and nakabantay na tayo rito. Titingnan natin hanggang sa lahat naman ng tulong na ibibigay dito. Ang importante naman, we're very much on top of the situation at alam na natin kung nasan silang ospital And sikasuin na natin to kaagad-agad as we speak.
Authorities are still investigating the cause of the fire and have yet to disclose the nationalities of those who died. About 200 workers reportedly live in the building. Let's now get an update on the weather from PAGASA forecaster Chanel Dominguez. Good morning, Chanel.
Good morning, Bettina. Good morning to all. We're currently not monitoring any tropical cyclone or low pressure area within and outside our Philippine area of responsibility. However, Easterlies is affecting eastern section of Mindanao, which will bring a cloudy skies with scattered rain showers and thunderstorm over Davao Oriental, Davao Occidental, South Cotabato, Sarangani, Sultan Kudarat, and Zamboanga, Cebu. For the rest of our country, expect a generally fair weather with the chances of localized thunderstorm during the afternoon and the evening. That's the latest in PAGASA Weather Forecasting Center. Chanel Dominguez, and good morning.
Thank you very much for that update, Chanel.